I have been asked several times now about cortisone, in particular cortisone injections and their relevance and application in cases of osteoarthritis. So that would be cortisone injections into an arthritic joint. So I'm going to discuss very quickly in this video what it actually is, what it does, what it is good for, what it is not good for, and when you should or should not entertain the thought of having cortisone injection into an arthritic joint. So welcome to ShapeFixer. I'm Andrew. I'm a nutritionist. I have recovered completely from osteoarthritis of the hip. I was told I needed a hip replacement. I did not have a hip replacement, and I am now cured through a protocol of nutrition and appropriate rehab exercises. So where do we stand with cortisone? Okay, first of all, when you have a cortisone injection, understand that it is not actually cortisone. It is hydrocortisone, which is slightly different. And what hydrocortisone actually is, once it gets inside and starts acting, is cortisol. It's a synthetic or man-made version of cortisol, which is a hormone produced by your own body and sometimes called your stress hormone. So you are having your stress hormone injected into the joint or into the muscle or into the tendon or wherever you're having your cortisone injection. And what it does is it works very effectively as an anti-inflammatory. So it will lower your pain, it will lower the inflammation. It does that by interfering with your immune system. Okay, it depresses your immune system, thereby reducing the inflammation, and that is why the pain eases. So it's not a cure, it's a treatment. It is, I guess, like having a paracetamol. It's a Band-Aid that can make you feel a lot more comfortable, and so that obviously has some value. But because it's not a cure, the problem is going to come back. The injection is going to wear off over a period of time, and you will have to have another one, unless you do the things you need to do to recover from that arthritis. And that's not the topic of this video, but where it becomes a problem is the long-term use of cortisone can be very destructive. Now, not only is it your stress hormone that lowers your inflammation, it is also has what is called a catabolic effect on tissue. That means it breaks tissue down. Now, it's very useful in sports injuries. For example, a ruptured muscle or a damaged tendon where there tends to be scar tissue building up, and the injection of the cortisone or hydrocortisone not only reduces the inflammation and eases the pain, but it also helps to break down the scar tissue so that the healing is more efficient. Unfortunately, in joints with osteoarthritis, the damaged tissue is cartilage. And cartilage heals very, very slowly, to the point that a lot of people still believe it doesn't heal. That's not true. It does. Science has shown that it really does, but it just takes time. Because there is virtually no blood supply to cartilage. So cartilage, minerals and chemicals that are needed to build cartilage go in and out of the cartilage in the fluid, and they're not pumped through the blood. That's the main point. If you have a cortisone injection into your cartilage, yes, it will lower the inflammation. Yes, you will feel better. Yes, you will have less pain for a period. But the catabolic effect of that drug breaking down the tissue is going to break down your cartilage more. And the whole problem with osteoarthritis is a breakdown of the cartilage, which grows back very, very slowly. So if you are going to have an injection of a chemical into that cartilage, which breaks it down even more, your chances of healing become less and less every time you have that injection. So it feels good for now, but long term, it will do a lot of damage. So if you're trying to heal your arthritis with proper diet, with cutting out inflammatory foods, with doing the appropriate rehab exercises to strengthen the muscles around the joint and give your cartilage a chance to recover, to produce more collagen into the joint, do not have a cortisone injection into the joint. If your joint is so badly damaged that you have completely accepted without any doubt that there is no way you will ever recover, and you really have to have a joint replacement, and there are cases where that's necessary, then by all means have cortisone injections to give you comfort and a bit more mobility and slightly better quality of life until the date of your joint replacement, because that cartilage is going to go anyway. So you don't mind not growing the cartilage back because you've decided you're going to have a hip replacement. Then it's fine. But if you are hoping to recover and you are working on it and you're trying to get better, then cortisone injections are going to be a very bad idea. And that's the bottom line. They work. They work to make you feel better. They don't work to cure anything. So understand what's at stake when you are faced with the decision of whether or not to have a cortisone injection into a joint when your cartilage is damaged. Muscle damage, tendon damage, ligament damage, that's all fine. You don't want to have it too often, but in dire cases, it's not going to stop your muscle from recovering if you're suffering, say, from a sports injury. Okay, and that's the bottom line. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to the channel so you don't miss any of our new content. I'm going to do a video shortly on PRP therapy, which is platelet-rich plasma, which is an injection of elements of your own blood into a joint. And the theory behind that is that it will help your cartilage recover. I'm going to discuss that in a separate video, what that actually is, what it does do and what it doesn't do, and whether or not that is a good idea to treat osteoarthritis. Thank you very much for your time. Please share this video and, as I said, please subscribe to our channel.